Most home movie makers are filming for their own amusement, but for some it's the start of a career and a portrait of great talent before they became world famous.
Now, it's...
Monty Python's Flying Circus!
Monty Python's Flying Circus is one of our most celebrated comedies. The show's anarchic, surreal, and sometimes just plain silly humour has been entertaining audiences since 1969.
He's a chirpy little fellow, isn't he? Isn't he a chirpy little fellow?
And it made the Python team stars.
Is that the fire brigade?
No, sorry, wrong number.
That phone's not stopped ringing all day.
Python member Terry Jones went on to direct some of the most successful British films ever. But Terry's unearthed some of his earliest experiments with a movie camera, shot long before he became a world-famous director. His films give us a unique picture of his fellow Pythons, Michael Palin, John Cleese, Terry Gilliam, Graham Chapman and Eric Idle, as they worked, played and holidayed together away from the limelight.
Terry, you've unearthed footage from the Monty Python days.
I think it's probably all about the same time. I don't think I bought the 8mm camera until we'd done at least one or two series of Python. I wouldn't have had money, I wouldn't.
So the first thing was capturing your parents at home.
I think I was actually trying out the camera, so I was just seeing what effects you could get, you know, arty shots, you know. And I like the idea of stop motion.
These home movies captured Terry's first attempts shooting on film. Here, his sense of humour and playful style is evident.
That gave my dad the idea to say, well, why don't we do something with the deck chairs? Deck chair going for a walk. Suddenly, lady deck chair comes out, and a detraction, obviously, but she slams the door in his face. Spins around, collapses. Oh, 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 oh. She takes pity on him. Come on, you can come in. So they go in together, and the door shuts, and time passes. Who knows what happens? Father deck chair and mother deck chair come out, and a little baby deck chair.
Slightly risque scenario between deck chairs.
Well, I'd never thought about it as deck chair sex before, but now you point it out, Kirsty, it is. That's what's going on. But it's very discreet, I think. My dad had a great sense of humour. Oh, I'm being surprised. Oh, what is this going on? I didn't know him that well because I didn't meet him until I was 4 and a half.
Because he came back from war.
He came back from the war, whereas we'd been just floating around with mum and granny and all these women.
Do you think that sort of manifested itself in this wonderful cross-dressing that went on in Monty Python?
I have to say, when I did we call them the middle-aged women, I did look very, very like my mum.
Terry didn't just turn his camera on his mum and dad and their garden furniture. He also filmed the Pythons at work and play before they hit the big time. This rarely seen footage, shot during scripting and rehearsals, captures a moment in the Pythons' creative history and Terry's love of wielding the camera.
I mean, I'd always been interested in directing ever since we started doing Python. Yeah, I mean, I'm interested in what things look like. And
it's also holding the camera, the feeling of the camera.
Absolutely. There we are, having lunch. Well, it amazes me that we actually drank, you know, before performances, you know. We don't even dream of doing that now. It was quite embarrassing for me to actually be there filming the rest of the crew.
Well, why did you do it then?
Well, I just thought I had to, really. Python was always much more successful in retrospect than it was at the time. I mean, when we first did the shows, there was not that feeling, oh, this is wonderful. It was always like, is it going to work?
So in a sense, what you were filming here was, in case we don't get any more commissions, let's capture this moment.
I think that's probably what was going on in my head.
The Pythons worked closely together, and sometimes that led to creative tension.
And this is John killing me.
A bit too enthusiastic.
Yes, it's like we always had a sort of a relationship. Like, I think this expresses the relationship between John and myself. I think it's what he would like to have done to me. I only ever threw a chair at John once, I think. We were the opposite ends, and there was an antagonism going on there.
I mean, there was also hugely talented people, presumably, and big egos.
I suppose so, though the whole idea of Python was to submerge the ego, which is why we never showed who we were at the end of the show. We didn't have our names and our faces there. It was always just the show was the thing. So we were submerging ourselves in the show was the idea.
At the end of the third series in 1973, the team toured Canada with a stage version of The Flying Circus.
The Canadian tour for the Pythons, was that quite a big deal?
Yeah, I suppose so. I mean, it was slotted in at the end of a big tour of Britain, and we'd done about 39 shows. And then a couple of weeks later, we went to Canada, for goodness sake.
Despite their increasing popularity, it was around this time that John Cleese decided not to make any more Python TV shows. Although the rest went on to make one final series, John's departure signalled an end to the Pythons on television.
And here you are recording this again. Was it recording for posterity?
I just wanted to use the camera, and I just wanted to actually see what would happen with it, with the camera, and get the idea of... I'm trying to experiment all the time, like, you know, going to the mirror and then going wide, and then the idea of speed. I don't know
where I'm going. All this experimentation was to stand Terry in good stead. He went on to direct classic Python films, The Life of Brian and The Holy Grail, establishing his reputation as one of Britain's leading writer-directors.
But in a sense, seeing this and seeing the stop frame animation before, you sort of get the kind of genesis of your own career as a director.
Yeah, I suppose so. I mean, it's you know, I'm sort of fascinated by how you can shoot things. It doesn't seem that long ago, though. That's the odd
thing. Is it really not?
No, it just seems like, you know, well, yesterday. I know it's a cliche, but it really does.
So in this Robin, we see Terry Jones almost practicing while he's one of the Pythons his future career.
Absolutely. He became quite a significant director, obviously directing or co-directing a number of the Python films. But what I particularly like is his kind of like early little sex film with the deck chairs.
Also, it's quite uncanny when you look at that footage of his mum, I'm afraid to say. It is Terry Jones.
It's deeply worrying, and I particularly thought of, you know, when he plays Mandy in The Life of Brian, you know, that is not unlike his mother at all.
It's funny, isn't it? I mean, it's very fascinating seeing chaps who are used to being in front of the camera professionally being filmed in private moments, you know, in a sense they don't have to perform. But all these chaps, all the Pythons seem to be themselves, they seem to sort of be in character, they're offset.
Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of kind of lurking around, but there's still not that sense, almost, of them being aware of quite how famous they are. And perhaps it was at that moment they weren't the superstars that they were to become, even though Monty Python's Flying Circus was almost at the end of its run at that point.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Thank you.
I put a spell on you. Because you're mine. Stop the things you do. What's up? Spell on you.